Hi, I'm Scott Chipe. I'm with Water Advocacy. I'm at the 32nd Annual International Water Tasting in Berkeley Springs, West Virginia. It's Saturday, February the 25th, 2022. And I'm the honor to be with Emmanuel Itier. And he is running for president of France.
I was, you know, I didn't get the signature, so now I'm running for Congress.
Yesterday, he was the keynote speaker. He's produced numerous
films, documentaries, commercials.
Yes, just incredible array of all subjects, including water. And that's why he's here, Berkeley Springs. So his passion really intrigued me yesterday. I enjoyed his talk and his passion talking about water. So why don't you go talk about your next project that you're working on?
Absolutely. Well, to back up, for the last 15 years now, I've been traveling the world trying to understand who are we? You know, why isn't it functioning better?
Right.
Obviously, we have crises every single day.
That's correct.
Whether it's in our home or right now in Ukraine. Yeah, it's ridiculous. We have such a rich planet. We have water is everywhere, 66 to 70% of the planet and within us. There is resources everywhere, money everywhere. Money grows on tree. Yes, money grows on tree. So why are we in crisis? Well, the reason is because people don't realize that I am because we are. They don't realize we are so connected to each other, so interdependent from each other, and so complementary. You know, if 8 billion people would wake up every day saying, hey, how can I help you, buddy? You know, here are my resources, here are my skills. I just want to help you. It looks like you are in a difficult position. Let me help. It will be a different world. So that's what I've been doing for the last 15 years, going all around the world, tackling with big subject. You know, my first subject was God. I mean, talk about a big subject. I'm a little bit reconciled with God, I have to say. And then I did women. I'm a little bit reconciled with women too. As a Frenchman, it's a necessity, right? And I did a movie on economics, politics, health, nutrition, the environment. The last one that was completed last year was on war and peace. And absolutely, this time around, I'm doing water. Mm-hmm. H2O, the intelligence of water. Mm-hmm. So it's about trying to figure out what is this organic, maybe spiritual relationship that we have with water. Mm-hmm. Spiritual is coming from the word spirit, which in Latin, espiritu, means the breath. So all I want to do is give back the breath to people, especially right. After 2 years of COVID, where we've been masked and right. Scared. We need to breathe, we need to feel alive. Right. And water, obviously, makes us feel alive.
Right.
Not that I don't like a good scotch, you know, bring me a bottle anytime, I'm ready. But, you know, water obviously right. Pumps you up, gives you the energy.
Well, it's kind of like my site. I've done 3,000 videos, short videos, of course, on 360 different subjects on water for the last 12 years. And I did it because there was just a lot of unique subjects that no one really understood. And they were like little commercials of what this particular task is, to try to give you a full picture of water from source water to the tap and the journey, I call it. So that's what my site is really all about. But you're right on, spot on. I mean, the third world countries today that are still drinking, we still have 2 million people that die from dysentery, typhoid, cholera every single year. Why? This day and age, when we have all this money
The distribution, the technology.
It just makes me crazy. I mean, that's kind of why I started it, was to do better education. Even in this country, we still have 30 million septics and wells with questionable water.
Yeah, well, look at what happened in Flint.
Of course, Flint, I ran Cumberland. I failed the lead rule. Governor Schaefer put me on the lead task force. I went to Flint. I was on the lead task force for President Obama, representing Maryland, Delaware, and D.C., and it was a wake-up call. And we still have over 1,000 utilities that have super lead. Luckily, they signed into law to finally replace the remaining 12 million services that we have, that we've known about for decades, that people have ignored because of the price tag.
That's terrible.
Yeah, and that was what my talk was yesterday. The economics of water rates, of where the evolution of where we've come, And it right now we're at a stymie. It's just a bad, it's a bad time in this country right now because of where the water rates are where they've gone to in the last decade. They've gone up almost 100% in 10 years. Yeah. And in my career, 40 some years, I mean, like I said, I remember when there was a $5 water bill every month. And then today, you know, and now the water bill is $100 a month in many utilities, as I showed yesterday from the tariffs from the state websites. But anyway, you're spot on where you are. I mean, find somebody that cares about human beings this day and age. It's very rare, and you're refreshing to meet somebody that cares that much about human beings. And that was when I got out of your talk because. You're just a kind-hearted person.
Thank you. Yeah, I think that's the thing. It's to remind us that we should care a bit more.
Yeah.
You know, because again, if we don't take care of each other, it dissolves, and that's the problem today. I think the crisis is a reflection of the explosion of the human tissue. There is no more human tissue, human relationship. It's all gone, and especially with this device. People are so narcissistically focused on me, myself, and I. No, it's me, myself, and we.
That's correct.
Because without the we, again, there is nothing.
Right.
You know, there is no love, there is no exchange of services, of money, of anything. So, yes, you need to care, wake up and care.
Yeah, I just remember 30 years ago going into the airport, and I'd sit and talk to, 25 people. And now you go to the airport, and nobody even looks up, and I go, I'm just looking, you know, and nobody wants to, you know, they're all doing this,
and yeah, they're masked and they are into their phone. It's
and it just makes you because you know in the old days, I mean, everywhere you went, people wanted to talk
exactly,
and everybody interchanged ideas, you know, and they learned about what you did, I did. And it was a fun time to be in the world.
Yeah, but it's going to come back with people like you and I who are showing the example.
I do.
It's a question of leadership. You know, if we had leaders who would get together in a room, in a peace room, and figure out their differences instead of showing who's got the bigger tank. It's like, really? That we are still at the cave age? I guess so. I mean, it's sad.
Right.
So we need to get rid of all of them, and you need to run for office, like me, you know, or like him.
right. Well, like I said, I was real impressed with you. You're refreshing.
Thank you so much.
Thank you very much.
I appreciate it, my friend.
You're the best.
Peace and love.
Peace.
Care. I dare you to care.
Thank you.